God, who?
I'm sorry, everyone. It's Ingrid. Ingrid is dead. Out on the south terraces, she has been shot with Mr. Inglethorpe's pistol. I recognised it from the gun cabinet in the hallway.
Oh my goodness, how terrible.
This wasn't...
What's that, Eva?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all. I just can't believe it. In shock.
I need to know exactly where you all were when the gunshot was heard. Hattie and Meryl, you were with us in the hallway. What about you, Flora?
I was in here with Mrs. Wheatley.
That's right.
And you, Tuppence?
We were out for a walk. Me, Eva, and Agatha.
Correct.
Something just is not adding up here. Every single one of you has an alibi.
We found this.
A card?
Yes, on Ingrid's body, in her pocket.
What does it say?
It's a postcard.
From who?
From your father.
Mr. Inglethorpe. He sent a postcard to Ingrid.
It would appear so. Some 5 years ago. It seems they knew each other very well. They don't appear to have been on the best of terms.
He never mentioned anyone by the name of Ingrid, I don't think. Do you remember anything of Flora?
Never, not once. Not that I can recall. Mrs. Wheatley?
I've answered that door to many, many visitors throughout the years, ma'am. I remember them all, but that Ingrid woman was a new face to me. Never even heard the name.
That's because her name wasn't Ingrid.
What? What do you mean, Detective?
Meryl isn't the only one here tonight under a false identity. Ingrid has also lied to you all. The ID we found in her pocket reveals her real name. One Miss Martha Richardson. Ring any bells?
Richardson. No, that does, yes. Oh, I remember Mr. Inglethorpe worked with her in London. She was a PA, if I remember correctly.
Good God.
But why would she come here under a false identity?
We don't know yet, Meryl. All in good time. All in good time.
The message on the postcard is rather concerning too.
What do you mean?
It says, I know what you did, and I've got proof. The red folder will expose you. It's over. Come clean.
Goodness me, what did he get himself into?
Me, Detective.
The note! We've all been so stupid!
Excuse me, ma'am?
The note that Hattie found with the corner ripped off. Sincerely, Mr... It isn't Mr. at all. It's MR, Martha's initials. Compare the handwriting on the letter with her details on her ID card. It matches. The ripped off edge of the note confused us. But I bet you, if we were to find the other bit of paper, there'd be nothing on it at all. She'd written all she needed to with an MR. Mrs. Inglethorpe would know exactly who that was, I'm sure.
She did act rather strangely when this Miss Richardson appeared tonight. Come to think of it.
She must have recognised her.
Detective, we need to find this red folder.
Absolutely, Sergeant Peterson. Mrs. Inglethorpe's study seems a logical place to start looking for it. I have a feeling it may unlock the whole damn thing for us.
Very good, ma'am.
One thing before we go, if I... Do any of you have any indication on your father's job, might I ask?
His job? He worked for the government. We know that much.
Quite. In what way?
Mr. Inglethorpe was in the army, did his bit during the war, and then spent the rest of his life working in Whitehall.
But what did he do? So none of you have an indication of what it was that he actually did, after he left the army, that is?
He didn't talk of it much, just told us it was boring government business.
Which aspect of the armed forces did he belong to?
I'm not sure. We never asked.
Mrs. Wheatley?
No idea. He never said.
The intelligence corps, I believe. I'm sure my sister told me it was the intelligence corps once. I didn't press. Never really had an interest in all that military stuff.
Just as I suspected. And what of Mrs. Inglethorpe? Did she work?
She did. She was a pharmacist for some time. Inherited her father's business. Quite the woman she was, too. She knew her way around an apothecary.
Aha! I knew this. I think things may just be falling into place here at last. Peterson, let's head upstairs.
Take care, everyone. Probably best to remain in groups larger than two from here on out.
I wonder what that was all about.
Do you think there was really a connection between your father and that woman? Ingrid, Martha, whoever she was.
Certainly looks that way.
Very queer.
Certainly one of the most mysterious affairs I've ever heard of. Well, as the detective said, the truth will out. They'll find something. But for the moment, I think they're right. We must stick to groups.
Absolutely.
Well, can we put the wireless on or something? I can't bear to be sat here in silence, waiting for someone else to drop dead.
Tuppence!
It's all right, Flora. Tuppence is right. Maybe we need something to put our minds at rest.
There must be someone else.
What's that, dear?
I said there must be someone else here. It's the only other thing I can for it. The detective thinks it too, you can tell. That's why she's being so guarded. Think about it. The perimeter's secured. No one's come in or out since the police arrived. So there must be someone else on the estate. They removed the body. They killed Ingrid. It has to be.
Oh, there's more than one killer and they're covering for one another.
True. Every possibility must be considered.
I need to tell you all something.
Hmm?
Agatha, put the book down and listen. I have something to tell you. Tonight has put everything into perspective. It's time I was honest.
What do you mean?
Oh, for goodness sake, Agatha, stop looking at me like that. I didn't kill them, if that's what you're thinking.
Then what is it?
I didn't come here for entirely honest reasons tonight. I haven't been clear with all of you.
What have you done, Hattie?
It's not something I've done exactly. It's more something I've let happen. It's my husband. He's been taking money from Mother for years.
What?
He's been stealing our inheritance. It's his fault we have to sell Canons.
And here you tried to swoop in claiming you haven't had a fair cut of the inheritance when you've been sitting on the whole pile yourself all this time.
No, stop, stop. It wasn't like that. It wasn't like that at all. Mum offered us the money.
What do you...
Let her finish, Agatha. Go on, Hattie.
Well, he found something out, you see. Something about Dad. And given what the detective is asking about now, I'm sure you'll find out soon enough, so I might as well come clean. You know, he didn't talk very much about the war. Well, that's because he wasn't as wonderful as we all think. I'm sorry to have to tell you all this, but our father, he helped the Germans. He was a spy feeding them intelligence.
Mr. Inglethorpe, never.
There's no way. He was a proud British soldier. He would never have betrayed his country.
Well, I'm afraid he did. There it is. There were probably more than we'll ever know doing the same, ladies. I'm sure he wasn't the only one.
Oh, Hattie. No, are you sure? I mean, are you absolutely sure?
It makes no sense. If he was in with the Germans, why would he have continued working for the government even after the war was over?
I don't know, but Mum offered to pay my husband to keep what he knew quiet. So she obviously knew too, and we haven't told a soul.
Blackmail. You blackmailed your own mother.
I knew you were low, Hattie, but I didn't realise you'd ruin your own family for money.
Look, I know this is hard to hear, but it's the truth. I'm trying to be honest. Agatha!
Come on, Agatha, come
on. I'll kill you! You ruined us! You ruined us!
Come and sit over here with me. Meryl, why don't you take Hattie out for a walk around the grounds? The fresh air will do you both some good, I should think, eh?
Not so fast. You all need to stay here. We have news.
We found something. Something you'll all need to see.
What is it?
Oh goodness, I can't take much more of this.
We found the red folder. Here it is. What's inside, Detective?
Well, it appears there was quite a bit more to Mr. Inglethorpe than meets the eye, Flora.
I'm sorry, I should have told you earlier.
What's that?
I knew he was a spy for Germany during the war. He spied on the UK and passed information to them.
I'm afraid that's only half the story.
What could be worse than betraying your own country?
Wait, let's hear what she has to say.
It appears that your father was indeed a spy, and that he did pass information to Germany, yes. This folder confirms that much. But it also confirms that he was a double agent. He was passing fake information to Germany on the orders of the Secret Service to draw other real traitors out. And that's just what he did.
So, Mr. Inglethorpe was good?
Yes, it would appear so. In fact, he continued working for the Secret Service throughout the rest of his life.
That would explain why he was so guarded about his work.
Indeed. He had signed the Official Secrets Act, so any details he revealed of his true day-to-day affairs would have been illegal. And it appears that an investigation that he started in his final years has continued to draw leads.
That explains why Mother was so happy to pay you the blackmail money, Hattie. She wasn't embarrassed. She was protecting Father and his legacy. If your idiot of a husband had blown Father's cover, it would have destroyed the whole investigation he started.
Blackmail?
My husband, not me.
We'll need to take this all down, I'm afraid. He'll need to submit for questioning after we're through here.
I understand.
But this still doesn't explain who killed Mrs. Inglethorpe and... Martha.
That much I have not yet uncovered. But we are close friends. Very close. Let's go over the facts one last time. Mrs. Inglethorpe heads upstairs to get changed. She's discovered with blood on her chest and no obvious sign of struggle.
Which leads us to believe she was poisoned.
Yes. Yes, it does. Later, her body vanishes from a locked room, presumably because some evidence has been left on the body which would give the identity of the killer away.
Ingrid turns out to be Martha Richardson, a spy working in government, discovered thanks to Mr. Inglethorpe's investigation. She's here looking for this red folder and winds up dead herself.
The two crimes just don't fit.
What do you mean, Detective?
Think about it this way. This all appears to hinge on the investigation started by Mr. Inglethorpe years ago. Now jump to this evening. Who would have reason to murder both victims? Who in this room would take the life of these two women in one night? Two women who, for all intents and purposes, are on opposite sides of Mr. Inglethorpe's investigation. One, the wife of our hero, and the other, the villain herself.
It just doesn't make sense.
Quite right. It does not make sense. We're missing something. And I think I know what. Peterson, Mrs. Inglethorpe's study, now!
I think I need to get out. I need to go.
What do you mean go? We can't leave, Eva.
I know. I need to get out. I need to go.
Eva, wait, you shouldn't be alone.
Agatha, leave her. Don't follow her. If she's about to sue a runner, you'll get tackled by the police and the gate along with her.
Eva, wait.
Agatha, come back.
Oh, let them go. They're so desperate, they won't get far.
For God's sake, Hattie, use your brain. Don't you think this is all a little queer? Why would Eva react that way? What if she's the killer and your sister just ran off with her into the night?
For God's sake, she's not going far. She left her jacket here on the sofa, look.
It is a little concerning, Hattie.
My lord, write how's about I take the jacket out to her and keep my eye on whatever's going on out there. Will that make you all feel better? I'll...
What's that?
It looks like...
Poison.
You don't think...
Yes. Yes, look, it says right there on the label, toxic to human. It is poison. Why on earth would she have this unless she's... Ava's the killer.
The police, get the police now or Agatha's arm, I'm with her. I'll get them now.
She did say she was a scientist. She'd have access to these chemicals, then wouldn't she? Oh God, why didn't we make the connection?
Have we done it? Did we get her?
We may well have, Hattie. You may well have.
Let's just wait and see, shall we?
Best to wait and see what the detective had to say about this. Don't touch it, don't pick it up. Leave it exactly where it is. You don't want to get any of it on your skin or anything if it's toxic.
Quite right. Best to leave it where it is. They... Agatha, Eva, you're back.
Yes, you're back. Why? What's the matter? What? What's the matter? Why are you all looking at me like that?
Agatha, get over here by me.
What?
By me, over here, right now.
Not you, Eva. You stay right there.
Will somebody please tell me what the hell is going... Why have you got my jacket, Hattie? Why have you... Oh, so you found it, did you?
That bottle on the floor there fell out of your pocket. The bottle of poison.
What? It isn't what it looks like.
Then what is it? Because as far as I can see, you've been found with a bottle of poison in your jacket. When Mrs. Inglethorpe was found poisoned in her bedroom not more than a few hours ago.
I can explain.
Save it for the police.
You killed our mother.
Not now, Hattie. Not now. Let the police deal with her. You don't need to.
I'll kill you, Eva. I'll kill you.
You're a murderer. I can't believe you did
that.
Why would you do that?
Everyone stand very still. Mrs. Wheatley told me what happened.
Hattie, stop. Stand back. You don't have to do this.
Leave her, Hattie. Let the police take care of this.
If everyone will just give me one moment to explain...
You can explain at the station, Eva. You've been caught red-handed or as close to...
Hands behind your back, Eva.
No, wait, Sergeant, Detective, please.
You've lied since the moment you got here, Eva. Girls, we found a picture of Eva here at Canons in 1938. She knew your mother and father. Something's off.
All right. I admit it. I was here before. I do know the family. And I'll go further too, bringing that chemical here with me tonight.
I knew it.
Let her speak.
But I came at Mrs. Inglethorpe's request.
Go on.
And she told me to bring the bottle. She wanted that chemical here.
What on earth do you mean?
How did you know the Inglethorpes, Eva?
I knew of Mr. Inglethorpe through work.
But you're a scientist?
That's right. A scientist who worked for the Ministry of Defence.
So you crossed paths with Mr. Inglethorpe during his espionage days?
Correct.
And how did you come to know Mrs. Inglethorpe?
Through her husband. We had shared an interest in poisons and toxins. She's quite the chemist, Mrs. Inglethorpe. Not many females at the top of this game. I tried to recruit her a number of times. The MOD could have used a brain like hers. She was happy with the life she had, a local pharmacy, earning enough to keep her estate in her chair.
But Mother didn't acknowledge when you arrived tonight. She didn't say a word.
No, she wouldn't have. It was all part of the plan. I can't say any more, Detective. I really can't.
That all, is it?
Everyone is acting rather strangely all of a sudden.
Well, in that case, Eva, I'm afraid I have no choice but to arrest you!
Why are you shouting, Detective? This is dramatic enough without the raised voices.
Shh. I'm afraid I have no choice but to arrest you on suspicion of the murder of Mrs. Inglethorpe and for the murder of Martha Richardson.
Why is she speaking so loudly?
No, Detective, please, you have to believe me. There's more to it, I just can't say.
Stand back, everyone, stand back.
Shh, everyone be quiet, listen. Someone's in the hallway.
As I suspected, there is someone else here after all. Everyone back against that wall. Get behind us for safety.
Doubting me, Sergeant, are we?
We don't know for sure who's about to walk through that door, Detective.
Speak for yourself. I do, and here she is at last, our mystery guest. The killer is Mrs. Inglethorpe!
My dear sweet children, I'm so sorry, I'm ever so sorry.
Mother!
You're alive!
I'm alive.
And guilty. Open up your jacket.
Blood.
Martha's, I shouldn't wonder.
I might as well come clean. Yes, you're right. It is that witch Martha's blood. I killed her and I'd gladly do it again.
But Catherine, why? Why did you do all of this?
I think I can answer that question, if I may. The Inglethorpes are without money. That much is clear from the accounts we saw upstairs. Mrs. Inglethorpe really was trying to sell Canons off. But you knew that still wouldn't be enough to clear your debts. So you decided more drastic action was needed. You faked your own death tonight, didn't you, Mrs. Inglethorpe?
I did.
How?
I invited Eva here under the guise of one of the buyers. I don't have access to medicines or chemicals anymore since I sold the pharmacy, but I knew what I needed and I knew she would have access to it.
This bottle here on the floor?
That's right.
What is it?
A combination of tetrodotoxin and bufotoxin. It slows the heart rate temporarily and induces a coma. Too much and I really would be dead, but in the right quantity, it can be the perfect way to fake a death. Spies often carry a dose with them in the field in case they're caught so they can fake their death and escape later.
Sergeant! You can uncuff Eva now. She's played her part in this. I got what I needed.
You knew? You knew I was innocent?
I'm afraid I did. But I needed a way to smoke Mrs. Inglethorpe out of her hiding place. And I'm afraid you were the sacrificial lamb, so to speak.
But how did you work it out?
I started to become suspicious when we realised there were no signs of a struggle in Mrs. Inglethorpe's room and no visible cause of death. We presumed the blood on her chest was something to do with her cause of death. But then there were no visible injuries. So we thought it must belong to someone else, her killers. Perhaps Mrs. Inglethorpe had injured her assailant in the struggle. But when I could see that none of you had any injuries, I thought it had to be someone else, someone we hadn't considered. My suspicions only grew when Mrs. Wheatley mentioned earlier that Mrs. Inglethorpe had been a particularly talented pharmacist. It stands to reason she would know all about poisons and medically induced comas. And of course, when the body disappeared, I thought she would likely be the only person in the house, other than Mrs. Wheatley, with a key to her own room.
You're right. I'm sorry. I just didn't think I didn't think she would be using it, so I didn't say.
I'm so sorry, Mrs. Wheatley. It broke my heart to put you through this.
But why, Catherine? Why?
We'll get there. We'll get there, Flora.
I hadn't planned for it to happen like this. Truly, I hadn't. I didn't mean to kill anyone. I had no choice.
I don't understand. Something still doesn't add up here. What have you done, Mum? Why didn't you speak with us?
I had to protect you all, Agatha. I couldn't let you in on this.
So you're going to let us live, thinking you were dead?
It was better this way, my darling Tuppence. Trust me. I faked my own death in the hope that Hattie would hear of it and I could escape from the constant blackmailing of her husband. So when she turned up here tonight, I thought, even better. She'll know about my death and let the family finances be free. Her husband had found out, you see, about Mr. Inglethorpe's past, or at least enough of his past to cause issues should he tell anyone what he knew. So I agreed to pay him and keep him quiet. But I couldn't keep it up any longer. I needed a way out. This was the only way I could see to protect my husband's work, save the family from ruin and escape with my dignity.
How did your husband know Martha, Mrs. Inglethorpe?
He was investigating her, wasn't he?
He was, and he stumbled into something bigger than he intended. Martha was a mole placed deep inside the Home Office. She had been there for years. She helped the Germans during the war. When Germany lost, she turned to the next enemy. She's been passing information to the Russians for years. He was so close to gathering enough evidence on her that he could go to the authorities just before he died. That was the red file. I've often thought she had a hand in his death too, if I'm entirely honest.
So I imagine her turning up was something of a spanner in the works for your escape plan.
Quite. My husband had always shown me pictures of her, told me to be careful if she ever came to the house. He told me to protect the red folder with my life. I knew the second she arrived that it was what she was after. I tried to sneak it out of the house with me before she got to it, but she chased me out in the south terraces. She had taken Mr. Inglethorpe's gun from the case in the hallway and turned it on me. I fought back, and the gun went off. You must trust me, ladies. I never meant to hurt anyone. Never.
Self-defense.
Yes, if Ingrid turned the gun on you first, it was self-defense. Isn't that right, Detective?
You are correct, Mrs. Monkhouse.
So Mother isn't guilty?
Providing the investigations of the crime scenes add up, fingerprinting and so on, your mother will be fully exonerated.
We'll need to take the red folder too, Mrs. Inglethorpe. It is important that it is given to the Secret Services. I'm sure you'll agree.
I understand, yes. The secret's out now. She's gone. There's no need to protect it any further. They may be able to find some more information in there too, so please do share it.
I imagine someone from the Secret Service will want to speak with you all soon too. You'll likely have to sign the Official Secrets Act. I doubt they'll want this out in the open.
So, what had you planned after Martha was killed?
I retreated to the basement. I planned to wait there until I could sneak out with the red file.
But then we found it.
Exactly. I really did think the game was up, but I still thought I could escape Hattie's blackmail if I kept my head down and snuck out when things were coming down. But you called my bluff.
I knew you wouldn't let an old friend go to jail in your place.
Quite right. I could never have lived with myself if Eva had been in prison for my actions. I'm so sorry you've been caught up in this, Eva.
Not at all, Catherine, not at all. You're safe, the mole is dead. That's all that matters.
You're such a dear, dear friend, Eva.
But what about Hattie's blackmail?
It's over. I promise you all, it's over.
You'll make sure of it.
I'll make sure of it the second I can. And I'll see to it that my husband gives the money back. We don't need to sell Canons after all.
Oh, Hattie, I always knew you'd come back to us.
Not so fast with the hugging. It'll take time. But I'd like to, you know. Well, I'd like to come back if you'd let me.
Of course.
I'll never take family for granted ever again. Ever. You're welcome at Canons whenever you'd like.
Thank you, Toppin.
How's about I rustle up a cup of tea for everyone? It's been quite a night.
Oh, goodness me, a cup of tea will be just the ticket. Thank you, Mrs. Wheatley.
No problem. Consider it done.
Congratulations, Detective. I've read about you, you know, in the papers. The Met's first female detective. They weren't lying when they said you were brilliant.
Thank you, Mrs. Inglethorpe. Of course, we mustn't forget Sergeant Peterson here. She too was very much part of our success this evening.
Thank you, ma'am.
Not at all. Well deserved. But it's like I always say, ladies, the truth will out.